here. Y'all all right? All right. Let's look at some. Your Ukanai. What happened? Is it me or is it somebody else? It's me. I'm sorry, sweetie. I speak Ya'ukanan, chapter 6. Did I say something that you missed? It was something that you missed, Nick?
I want to sit over
there. She said she want to sit over here, Chris. That's right. Let's put her where she want to be at. She said, I want to hear. All right, this is Ya'ukanan, chapter 6, at verse 44. Listen to the book. No man can come to me
except the Father which hath sent me draw him.
Except the Father which hath sent me draw him. Come on.
And I will raise him up at the last day.
He said, I'll raise him up at the last day. Tell him what's written, son.
It is written in the prophets.
And they shall do what?
Be all taught of all Ahim.
They shall all be taught of all Ahim. Listen.
Every man therefore that hath heard
and had learned
of the Father
cometh
unto me.
That's why we are here. Y'all hear me? That's why we're here. We try to be taught of him. So we start to look at patterns of behavior. We understand consistency of behavior. You understand? Understanding just how the law works and how the law can't be impeded. Y'all got me? You can't go over. It has to be rightly divided. Let's look at something. The sixth chapter of the book of Ephesians. Listen.
At verse 1.
Listen.
Children, obey your parents in Yahuwah.
Y'all hear this? Children, obey your parents where?
In Elohim.
For what happens, son?
For this is right.
Y'all did hear that, right? This is right. What do they want you to do?
Honor thy father and mother.
Honor thy father and thy mother.
Which is the first commandment with promise.
That's the first commandment with promise. For what reason, son?
That it may be well with thee.
That it may be well with thee.
And thou mayest live long on the earth.
Y'all hear this? That's why we're here. He says, so that you might live long upon the earth. At the eighth chapter of the book of Ya'ukanan, 8 and 28. Listen.
Then said Yahusha unto them, when ye have lifted up the Son of Man,
then
shall ye know that I am he.
And what happened, son?
And that I do nothing of myself.
Listen.
But as my Father hath taught me.
As my Father hath taught me.
I speak these things.
Yes.
And he that sent me is with me.
Y'all hear this? And he that has sent me is with me.
The Father hath not left me alone.
The Father hath not left me alone.
For I do always those things that please him.
That's what he look at. I do always those things that please him. So now we want to look at the fifth chapter of the book of Ya'ukanan. 5 and 39. Other brother, you don't get me the book of Al-Ashamut. The 20th chapter. Give me about the sixth verse. Ya'ukanan, chapter 5 at verse 39. Listen.
Search the scriptures.
Search
the scriptures.
The scriptures.
For in them you think you have eternal life.
For in them you think you have eternal life.
And they are they.
Which doth what?
Testify of me.
He said they talking about me. Y'all hear that? He said they talking about me. Whenever you go back, then you go back to research or read, you can see the correlation. You can see where it talks about. It's actually talking about him. But then we take it, it's actually directed to him. Where it's talking about him, then it actually shows you where it directs toward us, that we follow the same pattern. You got me? He did as Cuff told us, he left us an example. that we should follow his steps. Who did, what was it? No sin, neither. No deceit found in his conversation. The problem we have now, a lot of us have deceitful conversation. We'll tell you something based on deceit. We're deceptive in our speech, and that's something he was not. Y'all got me? Because people don't understand his speech, they tend to think that he was deceptive when he actually wasn't. At the 8th chapter of Yehukanan, right quick, 8 and 30. So he got me, all Ashamut, the 20th chapter. Hold that for me. Listen.
As he spake these words, many believed on him.
Many believed on him. Then?
Yahusha. Then said Yahusha to those Yahudim.
That did what?
Which believed on him.
If you do what?
Continue in my word.
Then?
Are you my disciples indeed?
Tell them what you're going to know, son.
And you shall know the truth.
Tell them what the truth is going to do.
And the truth shall make you free.
Y'all hear that? When he was speaking, he was talking to the Yahudim that believed on him. He let them know that you're going to have to continue, which means there has to be ethanim, which is?
Steady flow.
Continual, sturdy flow, which means the same thing has to happen when it comes down to you obtain the spirit. You have to be consistent when it comes down to hearing and obeying the word to understand the speech. When you start to listen, you start to let other things come in, let other things start to happen, it's going to be a problem. He learned that himself. There are some other obstacles that will come in and it'll cause you not to be able to continue in the right path. Y'all got me? When he told us to go, write it before them in a table and note it in a book. There may be for a time to come that this is a rebellious people, lying children, children that will not hear the law of Elohim, which say to the seer, which would have been him, he was a prophet, and to the prophet. The seer and prophet were the same person. A seer was somebody, that could, they called them seers because they saw the vision. They weren't called prophets at first. Abraham was who we found to be a prophet first, called. In the book, we found it called an Abraham, but then we should have looked back at Adam was a prophet. Isn't that right? He said, for this cause shall a man. He never had one. He was prophesying, saying that you were going to leave your father and cleave to your wife. So Adam was a prophet. Huh? Even when you look at a man like Noah, man had enough vision to build an ark. Isn't that right? It was spoken to him and told to build an ark. Nobody else could see it coming. Isn't that right? A visionary, a seer. So now he's going to say, they're going to say to the prophet, prophesy now and does right things, speak of a smooth thing, prophesy deceit. Get you
out of the path.
Turn out of the path. Cause the Kodosh one of Yashra'el to cease from before us. See, this is the understanding that we get from these people. See, anytime people start to hear correction and people start to find their way and get real structural direction, it's easier to say, stop it. I don't want to hear it anymore. This is the same thing our forefathers said when they came down when they heard the word in the 20th chapter of U'Allah Shemut. Because there's some other things come with it. This is where a lot of people fall away. It's not just hearing the word and sitting here becoming complacent. When you hear the word, you got to activate the word. When you hear the word, there's some other action that take part. Somebody sent me an email and asked me about faith without works are dead. What exactly does that mean? When you look at the operation of faith, faith is the substance of things hoped for, evidence of things whereby the elders obtain. Well, I told them when you start looking at this whole action of faith and you talk about a substance of something, hope for evidence of things unseen, then you should be able to demonstrate your faith. I can't literally see it on the inside, but I should be able to see it by your attributes, your consistency. That's how we know Abraham to be a father of faith, but God a starter of faith, because the book said he moved with fear. In there, he showed you his faith, his confidence, his belief. A lot of us will say we have it, and you can't question it. I don't have to show it to you, but that's a lie. Everybody that's been accounted to have faith in the book is shown. In the 11th chapter of the book of Abarim, it showed you people that had faith. He said there were widows that refused to have their dead raised because of their faith. He said they were thrown in caves. They were destroyed by lions. He said they were torn asunder. They wandered in cave in sheepskin. He let you know, let you see all these people that demonstrated faith. So you can't tell me now that your faith can't be seen. Your faith can be demonstrated, and it's going to be according to the law. The law gives us our structure. Why is it that I don't impede the law? Because faith is not of the law. The law is not of faith. But the law was there as a schoolmaster, and it was a roadmap to get us to the Mashiach. I couldn't find it without the law. Because the hope of what I've taken on of this substance has to have something that allowed me to guide me there. I can't just have this hope and confidence in him and there's nothing to get me there. Y'all hear me? It's something that brings me to him. It's something that leads me. That's why I follow the law. When you look at Abraham, who obtained this by faith and not by the works of the law, but because he then transgressed the law. You hear me? That's the same mindset we have to take on. You can't be a transgressor of the law and tell me you have faith. Isn't that right? The whole reason why Yasakut obtained being in the place that he swore he was going to bring his seed to, it was because of his father, because he obeyed my law. He kept my statutes and my judgment and my commandments. So it was demonstrated. Don't ever just go account Abraham as a faith man and don't say he didn't have works. Huh? And don't tell me his works, he didn't show it by the law. Huh? This man was consistent. He wasn't a liar. When he went here and saw the king, Gerar, he told him that this was my sister. They said Abraham lied. He did not lie.
That's right.
That had been against the law.
Amen.
He said, indeed, she is my sister.
That's right.
She is the daughter of my father, but not of my mother. Abraham did not lie.
Amen.
These people said, well, it'd be times you have to lie like Abraham. You a liar.
Amen.
Abraham right. Lincoln told lies.
Amen.
Abraham did not transgress the law.
Amen.
Because of his faith toward Elohim. Huh?
Amen.
He gave him a word of promise. The mere fact he told him to get you out of your father's house. Huh?
Amen.
So he's going with what prophecy already have spoken and already been foretold and been spoken. And then the Most High done sent a Malachi to come in and confirm it for him. And the man got out of his father's house. The dwelling land he hadn't even been in before. The man crossed over.
Amen.
When he crossed over, he was no more going to be accounted as what we would call an Arminian. From the region of Syria. From around the region of the areas of Turkey. From around the region of the era of Babylon. He was no longer counted because he crossed over. The same thing, y'all. We don't ever count him as no Syrian. We don't count him as no Arminian anymore because he crossed over. Huh?
Amen.
This is the same thing that we've been taught by the apostle. If ye then be risen with who?
Mashiach.
Seek those things which are well.
Above.
And that on the well, that sitteth on well. The right hand. Set your affection. And not. He never would go back to his father's house. He would not go back to his father's house. Even if he came back, you know what he told him to do? He sent his servant to go back down. Y'all don't realize how important that is, do you? He would not go back to his father's house. Y'all didn't know that? He told his servant to go back. Even with Yasakut, when it came down him to look for a wife, when it came down his son to get with his mother, they wouldn't go back. She wouldn't go back to her brother's house. She told him, you go back and get him. I'll show you how that worked. I'll show y'all how that worked. Show y'all, you actually don't know this man. Y'all don't understand how that man worked. This man had perfect good reason why he did what he did. Y'all good?
Amen.
This one, what I got you holding, son? Give me that third chapter right quick of the book of Colossians, since I called it. Colossians 3 and 1. Other one still got me the 20th chapter of the book of Allah Shemut. I told him 20 and 5, but you 20 and 6. Make it 20 and 1. This thing right. I show him. Huh? I do just like Daniel told you. I'll show you what noted in the scripture true. When I get through, ain't nothing going to hard to hold me in this thing but Michael, your prince. Ain't but a few. Huh? They going to withstand me. People withstand when I tell you. They weren't going to believe I was going to show them the man's birthday. Mm. On time he told you to keep himself. He told you the most important thing you need to know when I die.
That's right.
Huh? Because he had to die to be born again.
That's right.
He told you to accept the corner wheat, fall into the ground and do what?
Die.
He been trying to tell you. I don't know why people missed it. Everybody that run around trying to celebrate their birth, like, I don't know what you're doing.
Right.
I never told you to celebrate it. See that? It was a snare. He told you he's going to be a trap. I'm going to be a gin. They heard the Malachis ascending up and down. They talking about peace on earth, goodwill toward all men. And they're sending you a savior, which he was. But he wasn't saving then. He couldn't save you then. Of course he was. They speaking of what was going to come to pass. Ain't that right? It was coming to pass. Ain't that right? He let you know it was born this day. And what day was that?
Third day.
That's right. The third day was the day you're going to need to know about. When he walked with disciples, he never did talk to them. Let me tell y'all what day I was born at. He didn't tell you. Huh? He didn't tell you. What you going to need to know, though? You don't need to know the third day. In the book of Oriah, he tried to tell them about it. He said the Son of Man told them they had to go to Jerusalem. Said the Son of Man got to go here, or to Jerusalem. Said the Son of Man got to go here and be betrayed and be hated and say he's going to be killed. And said the third day, so I'm going to rise. Thursday is going to be my birthday. Huh? Came along and tried to tell Nicodemus, set the man be, what was it?
Born again.
So he can't enter into the Shamayim. Yeah. Yeah. So he can't get in the king, got to be born again. Isn't that right? You got to be new. It got to be your birthday.
That's right.
Amen. You got to be new. Tried to tell these folks, except you convert, become what was again? Go ahead and come in. How you going to become a convert, become a little child? You got to start over. You got to be born again.
Amen.
You can't go back down no 10 years old. That's retarded.
All right.
So what it means, you got to start over to go back to 10.
Amen.
Isn't that right? You got to convert, become as a little child. You got to die, start, right? As a new baby. Say, you can't get in. Man, been telling the whole time, you got to be born again.
Amen.
Huh? That's this right. One you'll keep up with. Most important, when you, and you know when they come around, in that season. You know when they sat in that jail? How long it took you they sat in prison?
For a season.
For a season. A season for us become what they call a year. Y'all know that? The book told you how long they was in now. For a season. And you know what wound up happening when they were going to get out? On Pharaoh's birthday. Huh? When we got ready to come out, when we were getting ready to come out, Mizraim, he took, pick them the 12th chapter book of Ul-Ashamu. These folks don't know what they're doing. Let's examine some things before we keep moving. Ooh, all our Shemut, the 12th chapter. Listen.
At verse 1?
Listen. Other one got me the 3rd chapter of the book of Colossians. Other one got me the 20th chapter of the book of Ooh, all our Shemut. I told him the 6th verse, make it the 1st verse. Other brother, you're going to have to hold me the book of Barashit, the 12th chapter. Y'all know why I call it? Because it's right. Ain't no other reason to call it. I get sick of these folks around here making a mess. Heard somebody been going back telling what I was saying. So they went back and told the preacher, I said he was ugly. I bet on repent.
Amen.
Amen.
I bet on repent. I bet I ain't told you that every mirror ever looked at your face told you. If it could talk. That ain't the first time you heard that. I'm used to getting upset. Isn't that right? I know you're going to say, oh, you ugly too. Now you're added more transgression. 24 looks suicidal. Ain't no reason to live. Isn't that right? Obey that book. That's the best thing to say to you folks. Isn't that right? That's the best thing to say, get your heart right.
Amen.
I sure wouldn't be ugly trying to push myself around like I'm pretty. Take it, I'd be one of the nicest folks you ever seen in your life. Yeah, I'm too ugly to get upset. That folks just beat you and hit on you and said, beat me. You can't hurt me. I'm already scarred up for life. I ought to be just nice to people. Just be so gentle and kind. Isn't that right? Shouldn't have an angry bone in your body. Isn't that right? I'm trying to help him out now. Listen.
And Yahuwah spake unto Moshe and Aharon in the land of Mizraim, saying, this month shall be unto you the beginning of months.
He didn't do that. I know he didn't do that. Go ahead on anyway. Don't worry about it. Come on, let's keep going. Come on, keep going.
It shall be the first month of the year to you.
It shall be the first
month? Of the year to you.
So they're going to be the first month of the year to you, which means that if this is going to be the first month of the year, I'm going to use this. Once, I'm going to look at a couple of things. I'm going to look at what's going on at this particular time. I've got to look at what's going on at this particular time. I got to consider the weather. I got to consider the growth of everything. If this is going to be the beginning of my months, then eventually I'm going to reach back to this month again. You got me? So I'm going to be counting. I'm going to be looking at some things. If this is going to be beginning of the months for me, which means it had to be a dark moon. It had to be a dark moon. It had to be a dark moon. If this is going to be beginning of the month, this is going to be a dark moon. Which means if this is going to be a dark moon, if I'm coming out on the 14th day at evening, this is a full moon. Which is going to let me know this is 15 days. Y'all hear me? This is going to let me know I'm learning. I got to know how to count. It don't make sense to tell me this is the beginning of my months and I don't have no understanding. This makes absolutely no sense. I'm going to need to know seasons. Y'all hear me? I got to know how to count. I got to know the time is from sunset to sunset. I got to look at what position of the moon is. All these things, we the only people walk around, this is the beginning of your months. What am I using? Barashit, chapter 1. 1 and 12. See, they don't realize how important this is. People just think, you know what, and this messed us up years ago. We just assumed preachers just went out just preaching and doing stuff. You just kind of know. You can't just kind of know. You got to know. I'm telling you to do something. This is going to be something that's going to be perpetual for us. This, which means it's going to be continual, which means if you die and leave him, other people need to know the same thing. What are we going to say? Moshe gone. We don't know when it is. That makes no sense. Other people have to know the same thing. It's got to be reasonable. We got to be able to look at a couple of events. It can be cloudy. That can throw you off. There's a lot of other factors that can come in and throw you off, which means just because it's cloudy ain't going to throw me off, I can still look at what growth is. There are certain things that's going to happen in this season I'm going to be looking for. Because I got to start looking at, the wheat harvest. All these things would have been important for them. What sense is it going to make for locusts to come in and destroy something and it's still winter? It's going to make sense when the locusts came in and destroyed the harvest that things were growing. This is beginning. All these signs and wonders y'all don't pay attention to happen in 15 days. So I'm looking at what's going on. It needs 15 days. Because this is going to establish a month for me. This is a Kadosh moon. This is 1 in 12. Barashit. Now we got to become conscious. That's why you can't keep loosening everybody here and trying. That's why I get on these people, they talking about, Smith talking about people out here preaching and people, that's a lie from here. I ain't trying to stop nobody. You go ahead and make a fool out yourself. Ain't that, you don't care nothing about your soul and other people's soul, go ahead and make a fool out yourself. Isn't that right? People, you need to know. It's just like, you see, the man of God, he'll just know. He ain't going to just know nothing. It's got lined up with the book. Ain't no prophecy of the scriptures of no private interpretation. How you know it's beginning? See, it's just when you know, you just know. I told y'all, I can tell y'all when the man's birthday was. I can't just shoot that out my mouth. I got to show you scripture. I can show you what the man told you when you search it, they talk about me. He told you, had you believed Moshe, you would have believed me. He wrote a who? Moshe recorded for the, he was responsible for the first 5 books of your Torah. When Luke the 24th, in Ariah the 24th chapter, when he told them, old fools are so hard to believe all that the prophets have spoken, all they spoke. Ought not the Messiah to suffer these things to enter his glory? And beginning where? Why would he start off in the prophet and not start with the Torah first? He has found them in all the way. The things concerning who? Why would I'm going to go through them and cover Pharaoh's birthday? What does that have to do with me? The third day. That's my birthday. That's when I was born. This solidified me to be the son of Elohim. When you read Romans, the first chapter, it clearly told you concerning his son, Yahushua HaMashiach, who was born of the seed of David according to the who? Flesh. That's why that day ain't important to you. It's not a much important. They're going to be that he was the son. He was declared to be the son of Elohim with what? Power. That's why when he got up in the 28th chapter of the book of Matthew, he told you, oh, it's my birthday. I'm officially the son of Elohim. They don't know what they're doing. They think I ain't got no problem. What I preach, I can prove with the book.
All right. Amen.
It don't make sense. I'm coming over these private interpretations, telling these lies.
That's right.
You got to be able to see it. I can show you why them people came out their house. I can show you why they didn't go back. This is what I do for a living.
Amen.
Come on, son. Listen.
And the rich brought
Barashit, this is Barashit, chapter 1 and verse 12. Listen.
And the rich brought forth grass and herb yielding seed after his kind.
Whose what?
And the tree yielding fruit whose seed was in itself.
Come on, son.
After his kind, and Elohim saw that it was good.
What happened?
And the evening and the morning were the third day.
The evening and the morning were the what?
Were the third day.
What, the third day? What happened, son?
And Elohim said, let there be lights in the firmament of Shamayim to divide the day from the night.
Y'all see that? Showing you birth right there the third day. Ain't that right? Showing you the importance of the three. Listen, that's when you got light. Huh? That's when you got light. Come on.
And let them be for signs and for seasons and for days.
That didn't happen to a birthday. Signs and seasons. What that sign?
And years.
And years. What happened?
And let them be for lights in the firmament of Shamayim to give light upon the Aritz.
Yes.
And it was so.
Listen.
And Elohim made two great lights.
What was the sign?
The greater light to rule the day.
And what else happened?
And the lesser light to rule the night.
What did he do, sign?
He made the stars also.
He didn't do that till the third day. The third day, that when he showed you where the, what they call the S-U-N came out and it sprouted out and gave light. The third day was the birthday for the moon. When the star, he let you know what he did the third day. All right, listen.
And Elohim set them in the firmament of Shamayim to give light upon the Aritz.
Yes.
And to rule over the day and over the night.
Yes.
And to divide the light from the darkness.
Yes.
And Elohim saw that it was good.
Yes.
And the evening and the morning were the fourth day.
That was the confirmation. Huh? You were told that. Huh? He was going to confirm the covenant with how many? With many. That's what we are. We many. For how long? That's why he was counting down, giving you the daytimes. He kept telling you we use a card. We use our days. But they're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You should have been paying attention. You don't know the law. That's why when Daniel spoke, they're so stupid. They come up, the man died on Wednesday. Because they're so stupid. Isn't that right? They're trying to go back and trying to use the regular calendar. They don't look at the feast is a week. That's right. Only week is going to make sense for them to come back and show up was the feast week. Yeah. That would make us to be there. Otherwise, all of us ain't going to be there because it's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Yeah. But if it's a feast week, guess what happened? We're going to be there. So guess what he's going to do? I'm going to confirm the covenant with many for how long? 1 week, because you're going to be here. Yeah. And in the middle of the week. They don't know what they're doing. They don't know what they're doing.
That's right.
He realized, still, go ahead and ask them. They still going around. Died Wednesday. Died Wednesday. 3 days, 3 nights in the grave. Died Wednesday night. So he got a night. Wednesday night. Wednesday night. So we got a night. Thursday, we got a day and a night. Friday, we got a day and a night, which is actually night, day. But just, you know, because they ignorant anyway. Saturday, we got a night. Because our day started night, day. I was doing their way, showing their way. He died Wednesday night. According to what they say, well, part of the day. So he don't die actually the day. So then he got a night. Now you got a day and a night. So you got one and a half. You don't have a night for him. You got the day. That night going to be in him. Now you got another night, day. So you got two and a half. Now you got the night right here. Or Shabbat. This guy, him. Got him walking around in the day, dummy. This makes no sense. Uh-oh, another M. I'm Hebrew. Dummy. This gonna make no sense. Because at this point right here, he cannot effectively quote this conversation. 5:17, Yehukanan. Other brother, you still hold me by a sheep. I'm gonna shoot him down now. Pay attention. He would have had to die Wednesday before the night came. When the night came, they would have put him here on Thursday, which would have gave him a night a day. That's one and a half. Now we run over him. Friday, they call it. You got a night, you got a day. That's two and a half. He needs a night to complete. That will put him here at Shabbat night. This is going to leave him walking around in the daytime. There's no way he could have stayed in that grave for 3.5 days. He'd have been a transgressor. He told you three, now he a liar, which means everything roll and scroll up. You got him walking around on Shabbat. Listen to the conversation he gave you. 5:17. Yehukanan, listen.
But Yehusha answered
them. Otherwise, skill got me the book of Bereshit, chapter 2 at verse 1. Hold that for me. Listen.
But Yehusha answered them, my father worketh hitherto.
My father worketh.
Hitherto.
And what you do?
I work.
What does this conversation mean?
Therefore, the Yahudim sought the more to kill him.
Tell him why, son.
Because he not only had broken the Shabbat.
But what happened?
Said also that Elohim was his father.
Making himself.
Equal with Elohim.
He said, I do the same thing the father do. He just made himself equal. Meaning, everything he doth, I do. That's the one you can make something equal. If I gave you 5 pennies and I gave him a nickel, everything that nickel do, your 5 pennies got to do. Everything that nickel can buy, his 5 cent got to be able to do it. If his 5 pennies can't do the same thing his nickel do, it's not equal. Not equal. You can't claim that's the same. You cannot say that's the same. Same going to come out to exact. You cannot say same if it's not exact. Now, the man just said, I do the same thing. Bereshit 2 and 1. Listen.
Thus, the Shamayim and the Aritz were finished.
What happened, son?
And all the host of them.
And all the host of them.
And on the seventh day, Elohim ended his work, which he had made.
Y'all hear that? On what happened now? And on what?
On the seventh day.
Tell him what happened.
Elohim ended his work, which he had made.
What happened?
And he rested on the seventh day from all his work, which he had made.
So did it make sense? I'm going to quote, hitherto my father word, I do the same thing. I'm going to make myself exact. My dumb behind going to go die Wednesday. Two doing early. I'm going to wind up at night, and I can't stay in the grave for 3 days now. I'm going to be over, and I'm going to be lying. I'm going to be transgressing. With me, I got to get up and be out here doing something. Ain't no way I can claim this man my father, and I'm walking around on no doing Shabbat day, you dummy.
That's right.
This makes no sense. The Most High didn't do nothing. Absolutely nothing on the Shabbat. That's why he told you everything was finished. 19th chapter of the book of Yuhukanan. 1927. They'll take the book. Let's see what the book says. Let me read that again on the 2 and 1 again on the book of Bereshit before you get me 1927. 26 will probably be good. Listen.
Thus the Shamayim and the Aritz were finished.
Hold on. Thus the Shamayim and the Aritz were what?
Finished.
You say they were almost?
Were finished.
Barely?
Were finished.
Left off a little something?
Finished.
He said we're finished. What happened, son?
And all the host of them.
And all the host of them. Come on.
And on the seventh day.
What happened, son?
Elohim ended his work, which he had made.
What happened?
And he rested on the seventh day from all his work, which he had made.
This is the 19th chapter of the book of Yehukanan. Yehukanan, chapter 19, verse 26. Listen.
When Yahusha therefore saw his mother and the disciples standing by, whom he loved, he said unto his mother, Woman, behold thy son.
Come on.
Then said he to the disciple, Behold thy mother.
What happened?
And from that hour, that disciple took her unto his own home.
Uh-huh.
After this, Yahusha, knowing that all things were now accomplished.
What happened?
That the scripture might be fulfilled.
What happened?
Said, I thirst.
What happened?
Now there was set a vessel full of vinegar, and they filled a sponge with vinegar and put it upon hyssop and put it to his mouth.
What happened, son?
When Yahusha therefore had received the vinegar.
You say he hadn't drunk nothing yet?
When Yahusha therefore had received the vinegar.
When you say he was licking his lips?
When he had received the vinegar.
Tell, what could he have possibly said?
He said, it is finished.
He just let you know, I just purified the Shamayim and the rest. I just did all the work. Why am I walking around on Shabbat day? This makes no sense when you just read the Father did nothing. He was already trying to prepare them, you idiot. Look at the scripture. There's no way I could have been up moving around on no Shabbat day. Know what I tell you? That did my interpretation in that book. Wow. I mean, six in one hand, half a dozen in the other. You idiot. It's the same thing. That's error. That's why it's so important you got to be taught and you make sure it lines up, because you can only be saved by what you believe concerning him. If you believe and you're wrong, you can't be saved. Because the scripture is there scripture to solidify him walking around on Shabbat day? Couldn't be. Couldn't be. We know he had to get up on Sunday. We know he had to get up in the night. There's no argument, there's no dispute that it had to get up tonight. Because you got to know how to keep time. The same thing we look at when it comes down to Moshe. Moshe already going to know. Although they didn't have written law the way we had, they knew law. How did Abraham know? He didn't know no Moshe. He had no tablet that Moshe gave him. They knew the law, so this is nothing new. And he told them that he's going to write them in our hearts and in our minds. Yeah, Abraham didn't have no written tablets. That ain't nothing new. How new I gonna know what's clean and unclean to eat? How you gonna know how to count seven? He don't even know the days of the week.
That's right.
You gotta know law. So it was already written in their hearts and in their minds. He just had to tell, ain't nothing new under the sun. Mm. We're in bad shape. So we come back to look at the pattern in the 12th chapter of the book of Allah Shamut. We can see he had to know about the stars. He had to know about the moon. He had to know about the sun. We're just in bad shape. But thank the Most High for understanding.
Amen.
Thank the Most High for why we go back to look at these things. At the 12th chapter of the book of Allah Shamut. I'm sorry, the 12th chapter of the book of Bereshit. Let's look at a couple. I'm going to get y'all through. Y'all ain't ready for it. They say ready. I can help them out. I can help them out. I'm trying to tell these folks make a fool out of you. Am I the best they got out here? Not by a long shot. But I said, well, okay. Though, I ain't the least. I guarantee they ain't the least. I ain't the least. Y'all hear me? I ain't sitting around boasting the other man line of labor, and other man label. Ain't that right?
Amen.
I'm trying to tell you, well, our hands ain't work. I tell you, but it's amazing. It's amazing. It's amazing. Listen to the book. This is the 12th chapter of the book of Bereshit, 12 and 1. Listen.
Now Elohim had said unto Abram, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land that I will shew thee. And I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless thee and make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. Well,
hold on a minute, what happened? I wrote with red. Change the marker. Somebody stole my black marker. Come on. Here you go, Joker. Man, I grabbed it from him. Go ahead.
And I will bless them that bless thee, and curse him that curses thee.
Uh-huh.
And in thee shall all families of the rich be blessed. So Abram departed, as Elohim had spoken unto him. And Lut went with him, and Abram was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran.
Uh-huh. Pick me up at the 24th verse of Bereshit, 24 and 1. We're just looking at some things. That's all. Listen.
Chapter 24?
24 and 1.
Amen.
Listen.
And Abraham was old and well stricken in age.
Mm-hmm.
And Elohim had blessed Abraham in all things.
What happened, son?
And Abraham said unto his eldest servant of his house, that ruled over all that he had, put, I pray thee, thy hand under my thigh.
Yeah.
And I will make thee swear by Elohim, the Elohim of Shamayim, and the Elohim of the Arits, that thou shalt not take a wife unto my son of the daughters of the Canaanites.
Listen.
Among whom I dwell. But thou shalt go unto my country and to my kindred, and take a wife unto my son, Yatsukut.
Yeah.
And the servant said unto him, peradventure the woman will not be willing to follow me into this land.
Yeah.
Must I needs bring thy son again unto the land from whence thou camest?
What happened?
And Abraham said unto him,
what did he tell him?
Beware thou that thou bring not my son thither again.
Do what now?
Beware thou that thou bring not my son thither again.
Let me tell you something different between this man and us, truth be told. Now, he get me out of a situation, tell me to get out from my father, from my kindreds, from the land, and I leave, and I beget children. How is it I come up with, well, I don't want to be estranged from their grandparents and their aunts and uncles and other relatives, so I'm going to send them off to them so they can get to know their family. Because after all, he didn't tell me not to send my kids. He told me to get out from them. Did he say not to ever go back? But he had another understanding to realize he didn't take me out for me to go back. See, they don't look at stuff. Y'all don't pay attention. Oh, they guilty. You know, that nigga guilty. We don't need to deliberate. I got the rope right here. Why is it safe for me to send my kid back? Come on, if she don't go, Ryan, ain't that wrong if you wind up sending your son back and then he get one and come back? When we tried that with your cold, what happened? He got stuck. Wind up, he got frustrated. He looked at it. Y'all lied to me. I was stuck. It probably been a 7-year transit. I've been stuck in for 20-something plus years fooling with y'all. He said, I lost sleep at night. He said, what took it? I suffered the loss. All this junk I went through coming here fooling with y'all, it best don't go back. But the servant had no son realized, it be some women ain't going to want to come. What if I had just bring him over to her? What did he tell him to do?
And Abraham said unto him,
what he told him?
Beware thou.
What that mean? Don't do it. I'm warning you. Don't do it. Beware. What he tell him, son?
That thou bring not my son thither again.
That tight on all us, ain't it? You know what family going to say they hear this? See, that's that cult teacher. Yeah. Now the kids can't go and spend time, go back. I just want to go back and see where I grow up. Think about it. Who don't want to take their kids? I took my kids down the country. I showed them places I used to go. I used to walk down here. We grew up, we used to do down here. He said, beware that you don't bring them here to back to that land again. Abraham looked at it. And he told me to get out. He going to make of me a great nation. It wouldn't make sense that I'm sending you back there. He told me to get out from among them. It's tight. Y'all know what? We've been guilty. Let's just be honest. We've been guilty. How much been guilty? We've been guilty. We've been guilty, man. Call us out. Let's be honest. What's the harm? Because when they get them, don't tell me they ain't going to let them do what they do. I'm going to send mine out there for Christmas with them. They probably ain't going to let them play with no guilt. Probably ain't going to give them pork. That makes sense? No, it makes. That's why he got me out from them. Because of too much influence. People want to know, a lot of people, they want to realize, you know, when I get around my family, I don't know why it kind of overtake me. It's supposed to. That's why he told. Why you think he told not to go back? Because their influence is going to be stronger. What you going to do? You get back and you see auntie. Boy, come in and give me some kiss. Boy, sit down here, boy, and eat this stuff. You're behind, growed up on it. Yep. Now what are you going to do? You're going to come. You're not some of me. Yep. Boy, I changed your diapers. Yep. You better be telling me what you don't eat. Boy, that's your first bottle. Tell me y'all know what I'm talking about. They'll shame you on it. You'll be stuck then. He knew what he was doing. He knew when he told him to come out. Don't go back. We the only folk. How did I just go see him? He said, don't go back. What if she don't come? Beware. Don't send him over there. Y'all know that what make a lot of folk get weak fooling with him. You got to cut them off. Huh? These folk don't understand that, do they? So I can show. The man told y'all something. Hitherto my father work. I do the same thing. Pick me up the book of Matthew, Yahoo. This is good. I'm going to dissolve all doubt for you. Matthew, Yahoo 19. Give me 19 and about 25. Other brother, give me the book of Ori, y'all. Chapter 9, 23. Or y'all, I can help the nation out. Listen, first thing something happens, first thing people do, run back to their family. I know you're transgressed, you can't claim him. Last place you're supposed to run back to. That man weathered the storm. Listen.
When his disciples heard it, they were exceedingly amazed, saying, who then can be saved?
That's what I want to know. They heard what that man done said, untold that fellow, him, man, sell what you have and give it to the poor. Yeah, treasures in heaven. And Shamayim. Man went away sorry. He said he had many possessions. He said, listen, take heed. He said, easy for a camel to go through an eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter into the Shamayim. So they had a question. Who can be saved? What did he tell them?
But Yahusha beheld them and said unto them, with men this is impossible, but with Elohim all things are possible.
Tell me what happened, son.
Then answered Peter and said unto him, behold, behold, we have forsaken all and followed thee.
What happened?
And what shall we have therefore? And Yahusha said unto him, verily I say unto you, that ye which have followed me in the regeneration, when the Son of Man shall sit on the throne of his glory, ye also shall sit upon 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Yasharal.
Listen.
And every one that hath forsaken houses, or brethren, or sisters, or father, or mother, or wife, or children, or lands, for my name's sake, shall receive 100-fold, and shall inherit everlasting life.
That's what we're looking at. He said every man had to do it. Got to go back and look at Abraham. You got to look at Lot. He forsaken his wife. She turned her back. He wouldn't look back at her. Left her right there. See, that's why a lot of you ain't going to be saved. You think he let that man say he and lose a wife, and you going to get in with yours. You going to run behind yours. You going to let him go to get yours. He going to let you in. That man didn't get the second and third chance. First chance, he ain't turned back. He was told he got the city. Don't look back. That's why he established and told you any man had to put his hand to the plow and do what? What he said? You know what he tried to tell the book of Ariel? He said, remember Lot's wife. He tried to tell him before that, remember Lot's wife. Letting you know she look back, she ain't getting in. That's how steel-minded you got to be. That's how strong faith you got to be when it come down this truth. Because you can fool yourself if you want to. Your family going to have influence, and they're going to get you off.
Yeah.
Don't nobody make no fool out. He knew what he was doing. He told him, man, God, his father out and from his kindreds. Man, you got cousins, man, y'all like this. You can't fool with them. He already know if somebody in there got a pull on you, it's just better to get out from them. But I'm going to send the kids back. He said, no. Beware. Don't send them back. He looking at it. It ain't good for me. It ain't good to send them back. How they going to see them? You ought to do like I said. You ought to cross over. You ought to cross over. Let me show you something. 12th chapter book of Shumayal Booth, Beth. Chapter 12. Let's say about verse 11. Y'all make sure y'all stay up today. We're going to look at some stuff.
Amen.
Amen.
We're going to examine. And that right? He said, I'm going to show you what knowing the scripture true. And none ain't going to hold me anything. It ain't but a few. And there ain't but a few people going to hold with the truth. We're going to go back and look at relationship. Listen.
Thus saith Yahuwah, behold, I will raise up evil against thee out of thine own house.
Mm-hmm.
And I will take thy wives from before thine eyes and give them unto thy neighbor, and he shall lie with thy wives in the sight of this son. For thou didst it secretly, but I will do this thing before all Yasharal and before the son. And Daoud said unto Nathan, I have sinned against Yahuwah. And Nathan said unto Daoud, Yahuwah also hath put away thy sin, thou shalt not die. Howbeit, because by this deed thou hast given great occasion to the enemies of Yahuwah to blaspheme.
Y'all hear that? Because of what happened?
Because by this deed. Thou hast given great occasion to the enemies of Yahuwah to blaspheme.
What happened?
The child also that is born unto thee shall surely die.
Hold what you got, son. Jump on, give me 1 Timothy chapter 5. First Timothy 5:14. He's still holding me, Shemut, Beth, chapter 12. What verse we at, 13?
15.
Hold that for me. Listen.
I will therefore that the younger women marry.
Do what?
Marry.
What else, son?
Bear children.
What does you want me to do?
Guide the house.
Tell me what happened.
Give none occasion to the adversary to speak reproachfully.
He'll get an adversary a chance and wind up speaking against him. Huh? Titus chapter 2 at verse 4. Since he already over there, one of y'all grab it. I still want Ul al-Shamut, chapter 20. Hold that for me. And Colossians chapter 3, verse 1. That's a conclusion. There's a ground, Monty. There's a ground. Listen.
That they may teach the young women to be sober, to love their husbands, to love their children.
To be who?
Discreet.
And what else?
Chaste. Keepers at home.
Listen.
Good, obedient to their own husbands.
Good, obedient to who?
Their own husbands.
To their own who?
Husbands.
That's what Daoud should do. Should have stayed with his own wife. Listen what happened.
That the word of Al-Ahim
be not
blasphemed.
See, you don't give him a chance to speak occasion. And they gonna speak reproachfully. He said, therefore, the child gonna die. Y'all women don't realize what kind of power you got. Y'all don't realize how important it is for you to stay on the path. That's why we in a mess when the man ain't doing what he's supposed to and the woman ain't either. And the kids all out of loop. Nobody doing what they're supposed to do. Truth be told, ain't nobody doing what they're supposed to do. Everybody flip-flopping out, running, dropping, sending kids all with center folk to keep them. Who gonna do what?
That's right.
Who gonna do what with your kid?
That's right.
What your sending family gonna do? Keep your kid on a good, rigorous Kodash diet. Mm. Shabbat day, they gonna make sure they ain't gonna watch no TV. Make sure they ain't gonna play, go outside or nothing. Everything you done taught them gonna be corrupt. And they gonna come back and hate you. I was a kid, let me go to my house, I could play and watch TV, and it was on the Shabbat. And I was been ready to keep the Shabbat. I can go and eat what I want to eat, ain't got to worry about what's in it, asking all them questions. Who you think I'm going to hate when I come back? I'm going to hate you.
Yeah.
I'm going to hate you. You the one wrong.
Yeah.
When I go there, I have fun. When I go there, I don't have to do all that.
Yeah.
When you go there, you going to hell.
Yeah.
No, I ain't know what Yasaku. Be well. Don't send him back there.
Right.
Ain't no way you going to send him back there, you ain't going to mess up. Whole lot of stuff we looking at now. They done. Somebody, you're done.
Mm.
They can take it how they want to take, get married all they want to. You want to see them, come down here.
That's right.
And then Abraham said, come, when you come here, you know what rules him.
Right.
I brought that pig for dinner. It ain't coming in him.
Right.
And that right, you better put that junk in your car somewhere. You ain't eating it in here and put it in my garbage can. Dog tear that stuff on my neighbor's seat. That old hypocrite. You know, he'll let my garbage can get pushed over. Dog, pig be just spread all in front of a mailbox driveway. I ain't gonna tell my neighbor, my pig. Don't worry about explaining. That's all right. Merry Christmas.
Yeah.
Ain't that right? Chitlin bucket and fell over your family brought up. Not in my garbage can.
Right.
Amen.
I ain't mind nobody come out here drinking in there. You ain't not putting my, let me put you, you ain't putting no beer can in my garbage, flip over my neighbor think I'm drinking.
Yeah. Right.
They'll get an adversary be able to speak reproach. You ain't putting my garbage can.
Yeah.
Take Amen. That junk, where you bought it from, take it back and put it in their trash.
Amen.
They sold it to you, they should let you drunk it right there. I'm being honest, last stuff, no, I won't need no cigarette packs in my garbage. Take them where you got them from.
That's
right. We ain't blowing them, my neighbor said, junk done popped out, it's just laying in there, blowing, waving, going, knocking on my neighbor door, then run back in my yard. They look on, look, they care, like, who are they? Look at that. There's a cigarette pack on their yard, knocking on people's door. No, we all right. Throw that junk in somebody else's garbage, you'll be all right.
Amen.
He said, you trying to be too technical. Now he told me to stay in front of appearance of evil.
Amen.
I'd rather not have him. I don't know my God, man. I'm probably watching me before on YouTube. See, that's a hypocrite. Look at this stuff in him. Ain't that right? Folks know me when I go play. That's all right. Just take it some, take it back where you got it from. So this ain't going to hurt nothing. You right. Leave it in your car. Y'all all right?
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, these folks, look at that. They think about that thing, ain't they? Hey, that's our standard. What we going to, if we going, this what hurt us. In the 8th chapter of Yehukanah, we told you, then said Yahusha to those Yahudim, believe, if you continue my word, then you my disciples indeed, you shall know the truth shall make you free. They said, we be Abraham's seed. Well, Abraham sent his kids back to go spend the night? If he been called out from them? Well, Abraham went back to visit him when he was called out from them? Then why you claim to be Abraham's seed? See, they're thinking it's a cult, but I'm looking at where your condition is. I'm looking at your condition. See, your condition warranted this teaching because you're wondering what's your hindering with the Spirit because you keep going back relying on it. Every time a situation come up, you ain't never relied on Elohim. You always rely. I can always send them back. I can always go back. I can go see them, and they'll give me. Leave them where they at. Leave them where they at. They'll be all right. They're tight right here. That's right here. It's hot right here, ain't it?
Yes, sir.
Say that. Wow, couldn't come to my mind. Say that in Matthew Yahoo chapter 10. Let me say that what I want. 20 come to my mind for some reason. What's the last verse? 42.
I'm talking,
who?
42.
What should have taught them about forsaken mother, father? What is it, one? 20, 19? What's some?
30.
Is it 39?
Oh.
What is it?
32. On down.
All right, let's see. 10:32. Otherwise, I told him to give me Oriah chapter 9 and verse 23. Listen, it's the 10th chapter book of Matthew, Yahoo.
34.
34?
Yeah.
At verse 34. Let me hear what 32 say. Listen.
Whosoever therefore shall confess me before men, him will I confess also before my Father.
Hey, y'all know what we do. We don't do it. Confessing go not just with your mouth. You got to have attributes. So the truth be told, we've been guilty of covering up. Not trying to look exactly who we are.
Yeah.
Not trying to look at exactly what we in before men.
Yeah.
And he looked at that. Now, if you wind up pulling that now, what happened?
Which is in Shamayim.
Yeah.
But whosoever shall deny me before men,
yeah,
him will I also deny before my Father, which is in Shamayim.
What happened, son?
Think not that I am come to send peace on the Aritz.
But what happened, son?
I came not to send peace, but a sword.
What happened, son?
For I am come to set a man at variance against his father.
So that's why he told him to guide his father out. Very, they're going to set you apart. Mm-hmm. See, this is why you can't, truth be told, now, you can't actually claim Abraham's seed. Because he came to set them. This ain't against a father that's in the word or mother in the word. This one, you ain't in the word. We can't keep that relationship.
Mm.
He looked at, we're not going the same way. I came and I served you. I served you from them. I separated you from them. And I caused you to cross over. It makes no sense for you to go back. Listen to what he told you. And he still got me Shumuel Beth, 12th chapter, verse 15. Listen.
And the daughter against her mother.
Listen.
And the daughter.
They don't want to do that. Oh, I not get my mama always here. My mama always been. That's your problem. That's why you ain't never trusted Yahuwah. I don't make sense. Now my mama always helped me out. My dad always helped me. I always be there for me. And my sister and them. How am I trusting? I trust them more than I trust him. That's why a lot of men admit that they trust these sinners they can go stay with and Lord with. Something be wrong with it. I don't know no sinners that let me and my friend come stay with them. I don't know no nothing. I don't know nothing. My ear friend let me come stay that way. Ain't because I burn. They going to look at. No, not with me and what I stand for, what I play. Ain't going to work out. I could do that because you know what these folk don't. My prince, you know I'm throwing at you. I'm hitting you. I don't see it. I don't see it. I don't know nobody. I don't know no son let me come stand. Not me and my family. They ain't going to do it. They're going to be looking at it. I mean, y'all, because we don't believe the same exactly. It ain't make sense. But sure, y'all come on in. They look at it. You hypocrite anyway. You hypocrite anyway, so there's plenty of room for you. I already know you ain't all the way over. I know you got a foot in and a foot out. Y'all, let me tell you what I do. I watch a whole lot of y'all. Man, I've been seen past y'all. Y'all don't, let me say. That's your vision. Cause Jack crossed over in South Carolina. Man, my vision way down the street. Y'all too short, cause y'all got too much going on and think y'all be smart. Me, y'all don't be smart. Man, them degrees don't give me that look. That look broke, you don't got from them white folk. White folk don't even respect you when you speaking.
Nope.
White folk look at you, you be talking, be like, this nigga doing real nice, nigga. Tell you a nice nigga. You know what? That's a nice degree you got, nigga. They don't tell me that. Huh? They tell you, Thomas Miller, rebel. Rebel rouser. Troublemaker. Ain't that right? You? Nice, nigga. Tell you nice. Ain't that you fit in? Ain't that right? They tell me all the time. They tell me, you know what? I'm so fond of you and your education. And they love them. They don't tell me that. See, I already know why a lot of them can integrate. They can get mad at one. I ain't no fool. I already know what you be doing. These folks ain't fool me. Folks ain't sick like that. You sick in the head. Yeah. All these son of folks, just, I don't know no son of just go give me their car. I don't know neighbors. Man, let me tell you something. I got great neighbors. I got neighbors. Sweet as pie. I got some good neighbors. You know where we stay at? In our own done yard. Yeah. I ain't there for no car. I don't want to watch my kids and nowhere. My kid locked out, stay your behind right here in your yard. These folks don't. I don't want them to ask me about keeping nobody kid. Yeah. I keep them well. I don't want you to ask me for nothing. I don't want to ask you for nothing. Yeah. Henry Grady taught me where it's just unfortunate. I had to wait to do it when I was old. I tell you, stay out of here, let the folks do what they do. They be all right. He taught me where I just was too young and too dumb here. Stay in your yard. Stay out of their yard. Because you keep doing stuff with them, you're going to get trapped up, and they're going to get you on a compromise. Yeah. Ain't that right? They don't need you to keep that bucket of chitlin'. You've been going, letting them keep you. They've been doing stuff for you. Now you're stuck. What you going to do, be a hypocrite? Don't forget I helped you out now. Huh? I had you to watch mine. You had me to watch your kid. I'm going to ask you to watch mine. All right. I'm trying to tell you. I done learned. Man, y'all don't realize these sons are a lot smarter than us. He told you the children, they're wiser than the children alike. And they wise enough, they'll trap you up. They'll get you where you're indebted till now you like, man, that's a bad situation. Oh, man, it's going to look bad because I've been borrowing, been staying with them. I've been using a car. Oh. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you, and they need you to go Christmas caroling.
Yeah.
You talking about, but I was lip singing. No good way you're behind sitting there. Them. No good way you ain't staying no center house on Christmas, all them lights stuck up. You expect me to believe you just spend that in a center house, Christmas everywhere, and you ain't do nothing. How comfortable you finna be?
Good, man.
Or are you?
That's right.
Right.
I'm sitting here, everybody here celebrating Christmas, all these lights and stuff going off and guilt, and me and my kids ain't doing nothing. I definitely can't tell you wrong, I'm staying in your house. I definitely can't tell you this a sin, not staying in your house. With me, I'm going to go along with it.
Yeah.
Oh, ain't no fool. I already see these folks my way. Y'all think, let me tell you what I do. I just let a lot of y'all keep going to him. Because in your mind, you know what the good thing is? Pastor ain't smart as he think he is. He don't know. I just let y'all keep going. I see a whole lot further, y'all. I just see how far you going to go. Well, give me the mere fact you think I'm stupid enough that I ain't already seen you. I love it. It's beautiful. Otherwise, you because this step, you ain't going to be saved. You're not trying to be saved. You're trying to see what you can manipulate, get around with, get away. I don't get this. I don't know no sinner. I go run to and tell them to keep my kids. I don't know these people. Who y'all? How y'all get involved with all these sinners? Y'all got so bad relationship with these people. No, we too close. Because you're going to wind up sticking me. I want to keep it where we good and nice. Good and good. You over there, stay over here. I don't want to get involved now. When you stick me with something, it's going to compromise what I believe because they'll stick you. You got to learn how to keep things. They can think you being funny. Not being funny, I want to always be good neighbors. My neighbor, that her garbage can, by, I get my kid. They get the garbage. I said, take her garbage can, put it down there by her garage for her. She came with another thing. I'm going to bake y'all a cake. I said, I don't want no cake. Thank you. I don't want you baking me. I don't eat from everybody. Thank you. I don't want no cake. My wife made cake. Thank you. I don't want, stop it now. Let's stop it. I'm going to bake me some chitlin dinner and brought her. No, that's all right. Thank you. I'm just being honest. I learned a lot. I know a lot of y'all young, you don't realize it. Whenever you start dealing with neighbors, you got to learn how to keep things to a minimum with them so you don't impede and you always stay good neighbor. Over there where they stay now, the other house, my neighbor Elsa, how many times she can count I came in the house? I came in the house to help her do something. Y'all come with? Mm-mm. We good. Nice lady, too. I ain't never had a day problem. They didn't listen. She would offer me, she said, listen, my neighbor used to take, y'all, listen, God gave me a 1966 442 Cutlass. Gave it to me. He said, came to my house, he said, let me tell you something. He said, I'll watch you, how you keep the house up in your yard. He said, you want that car? I said, yeah. He said, my son, his son was a preacher at his door. He said, you can have that car. He gave me the car and said, if you need anything for it, say, I'll help you get it. He said, I like the way you carry yourself. He said, you stay in your own yard and you take care of your business. My other neighbor in there, she came and she told me, she said, you want a pool in your backyard? I said, a pool? She said, I'll pay for a pool to get put in your backyard. She said, all you have to do, my grandson come down here whenever he comes, just let him swim. I said, I don't want no pool. That too good a neighbor. That's fine. Gotta cut it. All my neighbors like, you know why? I stayed in my own yard. It took me to become a man to realize that you stay great neighbor. Everyone that can have anything to say, they'll tell you, he was a good neighbor because I stayed in my own yard and I stayed out of their yard. I did just like my dad used to do. Somebody need my dad here, he'll go there and help him fix it. He go back home to his yard. Stay a great neighbor. You tell me, don't borrow nothing from him. I was a nigga. He ain't looking. I run these some sugar. I'm going to go borrow some sugar. Need an egg. Run a car. He hated that junk. Don't borrow nothing from him. Stay great neighbor. He died for like, oh, man, he died. Mr. Smith. Oh, Mr. Smith. He on the fool with one fella at the house. Never went to his house. He sit outside. He tell me all the time, stay out the people's house. Taught me some good knowledge. I learned to do that with my neighbor. I stay out your house. If I come in, I'm going to help you do something I get through. I ain't laying around lounging. I ain't sitting around watching no tea with you. I'm back out your house. Because some get broke, some get stolen, some get missing. I'm gone. We're going to always be, listen, all my neighbors, we're going to be the best of neighbors. I'm going to stay in my yard. You stay in your yard. You keep them folks. You don't fool with them sinners. They'll mess y'all up. You can't get too overdrawn with sweet. Hey, how you say that? And go on back in the house. Close your door. They get to look around at them. How y'all afford that? What's that in now? Nigga, they young martyr, you know, they put you to the bathroom, nigga went all the, I see y'all ain't made y'all bed. You like, nigga done went too far now. You know, they put you to the bathroom, they're now opening the cabinet down, all right. Looking for pads and stuff, all right. Ain't got no scouring pad. You keep these center. I'm telling y'all young folks something. Henry Grady taught me good now. And my mom, I was just too stupid to listen. But I learned as I got older, you stay out these folk houses. Let them folk have their stuff. They come in yours doing rambling. They're leaving where they are. Coming in all corner, but foot laid all up on stuff. So, yeah, time. You go, yeah, I probably just spend the night over here. Hey, I'm telling some of my other friend, co-worker, all them folk to come on here. Say, so get the gun and start loading them. I'm going to help y'all young folk. I'm telling you something. I don't care how good a night them neighbor be. Learn where to keep folk. Keep them relationship on them front porch. They be good to go. They be like, man, they don't let me in their house. I don't know you like that. I don't want to know. That's going to be too much. Leave them sinners out your homes. Folk have something. We want to come have something at your house. Can't have it over here. How far have over there, y'all? My in-law, they don't have my house. One of my cousins, Kathy, said, woo, your house. We stood right there. We had a night conversation in the driveway. That loud mouth nigga had everything told. Just some folks, be honest with you, it just better leave my side in the driveway and talk to them. Then they need, see, they're going to get tired of standing. They're going to have to pee. They'll look down where they stand. Why a neighbor going to come to my house and need to pee? So, oh, you got to be at time. You're ready to go there, huh? So, I got to run now. Hey, but I'm gonna go way back to my house on AMP. Yeah, because they gonna come to your house and tell you how to pee. So that way I can get in and look. They don't think that. You gotta leave where they at now. Go on back in your yard and pee now. Go peel behind your tree. And I can't be peeing in my yard. This will help a lot of y'all out. How many, I'm telling you, y'all live a little time and get going with these names. You'll see how far stuff to go. Let your kids go play. Kid do stuff. You teach your kids to listen. Stay out of their house. Stay out of their house. Keep them out of your house. Y'all learn how to play out there in the street. Everybody, if I could just use my head. I hate that joke of the devil, man. I hate that joke. I said, man, that joke of just. Boy, he made me sick. I wish he died. I was looking at all my friends, all the stuff they got to do. They ain't going for how it be dog. They run down. Man, we had like that picture front one. Them niggas, I be sitting there and you need to run and jump up in front of the yard, in the one. Man, I be sitting there just looking, man, about to cry. Street, like they just making mockery of me. I'm just sitting in the house, man. They just running back and forth in front of that pigeon when the jump. Henry Grady seen it, he'd have killed them all. I'm sitting here like, here I am, stuck in their house, cause this mean old nigga, he needed to die while my mama married this joker. He made me sick. All of them dead. Appreciate when they gone. He tried to tell about them folk. Them ain't your friends. I'd be so done stupid, so ran to be with these folks. That old man told me some stuff. I'd have listened to that old man. He had a whole lot more sin than a lot of these folks we ever get. You can't get it from a book. Had to get it from experience. You get it, start learning. Leave them people right where they at. A lot of these folks, y'all be in love with these folks, be thankful. These folks not y'all friends. Y'all are learning. They'll show how much friend they be. They want to know how much you know, get what you got, and get you screwed up. Leave them right where they at, outside where you need to stay. Like, why? You'll be the best of neighbor with them for years to come. You die, anything, how they said, they were some good people. What they had in their house? I don't know, I ain't never get in there. That's why I'm a good person. You let them they get to looking too done much, knowing what you pay for stuff. Where you got that? Where you got that gun to run their mouth? I went there, how you need to come on and then the other neighbor show up. Hey, we ain't meet when everybody trying to get in your house, you don't realize folk talking. That thing know your house get broke in. Y'all hear me? I'm just being out. I learned stuff. Here, Greg tried to teach me. How many of y'all, they ain't had one of them older dads. How many of y'all dad, a parent tried to tell y'all stuff, y'all didn't listen? Thinking they just hate it. How many of y'all hate it when they used to tell you stuff? Time will come back and show you, though. A lot of stuff they told you. They were wrong on some stuff, or they might have been mean, but the way they did, they were trying to tell you because they want you to know it was that serious. The wrong person to kill you. A lot of people have died at the hands of friends. People they thought were their friends, they have died at the hands of these people. A lot of people that get robbed, you only get robbed from people that know you. I used to do it. The person that robbed you know somebody that know you that done ran their mouth, and that's how they got you.
Yep.
So y'all learned to do them neighbors. Their intent might not be bad, but the best way to find out, they have was a good conversation out here in this street. I got to get in the house. I got to try to get in late. All right. How many of my neighbor have it at home? They always stay neighbor. I mean, they member. I'm going to shoot Hayward anyway. That's different Hayward. You know what I'm talking about? These folks like neighbors, like, man, we got good neighbors. Some good night neighbors up. You know how they stay at night? Lean where they at. Had them good come say in the street and going back in the house. All right, y'all take care now. Man, you be glad. They be, hey, keep going. Come on here. Say, I'm busy. I don't want to come here. I don't want to know what you got. I don't want to steal it. Ain't that right? So I don't want to rob. Hey, you so crazy. So I am, too. But keep me out your house. I'll keep you out of mine. Around there spying and looking and telling, man, they got to, you ought to see what they got. I'm telling you, they be running them out with other neighbors. I'm watching. Yeah. Having the head kind of introduce myself, what's his name? Yeah, me and my wife, we going to come over there. I said, I'm met you now. We good. Going in the house. That's good. I ain't got time to be coming. Why y'all be part? I don't go knock on nobody's door to introduce myself. Get shot.
That's right.
I ain't never thought about going knocking on folks' house to introduce myself. Y'all be all right.
Yep.
I know when I ride. You that nigga live right there. I know all my neighbor names. You know what I mean? Yeah, you them white folk right there.
Yep.
Yeah, I name. Yeah, white folk. That nigga. I know all of them. Now I know their first and last name. Y'all good?
All right.
Well, he let me go for now. This will help y'all young folk now. See, I done learned the hard way. I had stuff stolen before fooling with people. Henry Gray tried to tell me now. Now y'all need a Henry. They need a dad. They need your daddy to bring. I need your daddy to come out here with that shoe. I'm going to tell these niggas some possum. I'll stop this fooling. I holler, possum. That nigga, that nasty nigga, just start beating with this shoe. Try to save y'all, man. Ain't that right? Bring your dad too. So I need a lion killing him. Joker tell so many lies in here, they study lying. Tell that I got some lions I need to come in and kill. I'm gonna help y'all out. Now y'all take your time now. Come on, finish this up. Let me show y'all how they go.
Think when at verse 35.
Listen, this is the 10th chapter of the book of Matthew. Yahweh at verse 35. Listen.
And daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law.
Listen.
And a man's foes shall be they of his own household.
Uh-huh.
He that loveth father or mother more than me.
Listen.
Is not worthy of me.
Do you see why he ain't go back? Because if I told you to do something, you don't do it. That means you love them more than me. Soon as somehow, let me tell you why something y'all do. Soon as somehow. I need to go shoot at my family. I need to go shoot. Y'all don't realize you keep showing where your love at for them. It don't mean that you, when he told you hate them, you have to learn to dissolve some relationship. Just like the prophet Adam told you. For this call shall a man his, and what he supposed to do? That book. I don't want no man. My mom, I be running back to go see my mama all the time. I don't go be hard to see mama. I see my mama here. She need me, so I go get her. And she in him. He said, you're supposed to cleave to your wife. I don't be running back telling my mama, bake me, mama make me. I got somebody to bake and cook right here. That mama, doctor, wife, friend, everything right now, roll into one. Y'all hear me? All right. Y'all be messing around you want to now. Y'all hear me? Especially that I wouldn't go see no transgressing mama. Not like they didn't pull away from her. He told you're supposed to cleave to that wife. See, that what these folks don't believe that. When Abraham went back and left Sarah to go back and look at one of the other. Go look, man, he with his wife. Half time he can go back and get it, boy. He told us, you can go back. You know why? You're not a minute. You can go back and go get it. When I can't go back. That's why he sent his servant. I can't go. The man told me don't go back. What did he mean by that? Let's break that down to interpretation. That mean don't go back in the room you slept in, but you can lounge in the living room. What exactly go back mean? Don't go back to acting like a child, go back home? He knew what it meant. He ain't go back. And he knew it wasn't just for him, it was for his children. Then that coming on, let you know how your law work. You're supposed to teach it to your children and to your children's children, and they supposed to teach another generation. Why y'all, this is truth be told, why y'all think we still, y'all sitting here, you're still transgressing? Because you hadn't obeyed, and you don't teach your kids to obey and stay consistent with anything. You got to stay consistent with what it is you believe. That's why Abraham is our father. And when you obey and you comply, you're doing the same thing. That man done sat here and telling you this. I came to put a variant with just telling you, if I'm going to claim you like Abraham, when I came, then you think that put a distance between him and his father? What you leaving? Why you leaving home? I got to go, me and my wife. It's like that. You don't think they're going to put a distance? They put a barrier between them. I put a distance. He said, I came to put a distance between y'all. They don't see that. They don't see that. Let me show you something. 12th chapter. Come on, finish it right quick. He still got Shumayal Beth, chapter 12. He left off verse 15. Finish. Hold on. You finish up what you got, son. You done? This is 10:35.
Continuing at verse 37.
At verse 37. This is Matthew Yahoo 10:37. Brandon got Shumayal chapter 12, Beth, verse 15. And he still got me Colossians chapter 3 at verse 1. And he got me U'al Ashamut chapter 20. Some kind of way I work all this out. Listen.
And he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me.
Uh-huh.
And he that taketh not his cross and followeth after me is not worthy of me.
Uh-huh.
He that findeth his life shall lose it.
Y'all hear that? He that findeth his life gonna lose it. What happened?
And he that loseth his life for my sake shall find it.
Come on.
He that receiveth you receiveth me.
Yeah.
And he that receiveth me receiveth him that sent me.
Mm-hmm.
He that receiveth a prophet in the name of a prophet.
What happened?
Shall receive a prophet's reward.
Mm-hmm.
And he that receiveth a righteous man in the name of a righteous man shall receive a righteous man's reward.
Yes.
And whosoever shall give to drink unto one of these little ones a cup of cold water, only in the name of a disciple, verily I say unto you, he shall in no wise lose his reward.
Come on, son, to the 12th chapter. Shumayal. So y'all know what all y'all got. Oriah chapter 9:23, Colossians 3 and 1, U'al Ashamut chapter 20 and verse 1. I need y'all to wait. I know I've been up a long time, but I still got work to do. Listen.
And Nathan departed unto his house, and Yahuwah struck the child that Uriah's wife bare unto Daud.
Come on, son.
And it was very sick. Daud therefore besought Elohim for the child. And Daud fasted and went in and lay all night upon the arits.
Come on, son.
And the elders of his house arose and went to him to raise him up from the arits. But he would not, neither did he eat bread with them.
Come on.
And it came to pass on the seventh day that the child died. And the servants of Daud feared to tell him that the child was dead. For they said, behold, while the child was yet alive, we spake unto him. And he would not hearken unto our voice.
Yeah.
How will he then vex himself if we tell him that the child is dead?
It's going to be a lot worse once we tell him the child is dying. What happened, son?
But when Daud saw that his servants whispered, Daud perceived that the child was dead.
What happened?
Therefore, Daud said unto his servants, is the child dead? And they said, he is dead.
What happened?
Then Daud arose from the arits and washed and anointed himself and changed his apparel and came into the house of Yahuwah.
Come on.
And worshipped. Then he came to his own house, and when he required, they set bread before him, and he did eat.
Uh-huh.
Then said his servants unto him, what thing is this that thou hast done? Thou didst fast and weep for the child while it was alive.
Yeah.
But when the child was dead, thou didst rise and eat bread.
What happened, son?
And he said, while the child was yet alive,
what happened?
I fasted and wept.
Listen.
For I said, who can tell whether Elohim will be gracious to me, that the child may live.
What happened, son?
But now he is dead.
Yeah.
Wherefore should I fast?
Listen, why?
Can I bring him back again?
Yeah.
I shall go to him.
Well, what happened?
But he shall not return to me.
See that? There's something separate us. Y'all hear that? He let you know there's something separate us. Not only that, you paid attention when the child died. What day was it? Shabbat. Shabbat. Guess what he rose up and did? He went into the temple. That was first. His heart was toward going seeing Yahuwah. He wasn't looking at my child died. Excuse me. I prayed he had me excused. This is a different situation. He looked at his first commitment was to Yahuwah. He went right into the temple and worshiped. Did not go in there and cry and beg, why, oh Lord, had thou forsaken me? Why, oh why? He went right into the temple and it was the Shabbat and kept the Shabbat. And worship. Came back and sat down to eat and realized, I didn't know if he'll be gracious and let the child live. But once he was dead, all I could do for him is done. Huh? Yep. He can't come back to me. I can go over to him. Yep. You hear that? It's a separation. It don't allow to get back together like that. Man. In order for it to come together, one of us got to convert. Yep. Daud going to have to convert to go the way he was. He knew he couldn't convert and come back to him. Don't worry about it. Come on to the all our Shemut. I told them verse 1. Go ahead and give me verse 6. Y'all ain't got long. This is going to be more they can handle anyway. Listen.
And shewing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments, thou shalt not take the name of Yahuwah thy Elohim in vain.
Yes.
For Yahuwah will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain.
Listen.
Remember the Shabbat to keep it Kadosh.
Yes.
6 days shalt thou labor.
What happens?
And do all thy work.
Come on.
But the seventh day is the Shabbat of Yahuwah thy Elohim.
Come on.
In it thou shalt not do any work.
Mm-hmm.
Thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor thy stranger that is within thy gates.
Come on.
For in 6 days Yahuwah made Shamayim and Aritz.
What happened, son?
The sea and all that in them is.
Yeah.
And rested the seventh day.
Come on.
Wherefore Yahuwah blessed the Shabbat day and hallowed it.
Come on.
Honor thy father and thy mother.
Honor who?
Thy father and thy mother.
What happened, son?
That thy days may be long upon the land which Yahuwah thy Elohim giveth thee.
Uh-huh.
Thou shalt not kill.
Hold on for a minute, bad man. What do you want me to do? Honor who?
Honor thy father and thy mother.
Yeah.
That thy days may be long upon the land.
Yeah.
Which Yahuwah thy Elohim giveth thee.
Pick me up at the 9th chapter, Oriah, 9:23. Other brother got me Colossians 3:1. Man, that's a wonderful way.
Amen.
Listen.
And he said to them all, if any man will come after me.
What he want me to do, son?
Let him deny himself.
And do what? And
take up his cross daily.
And do what?
And follow me.
Denying yourself going to be involved in your relationships, too. Denying yourself going to involve these relationships. Amen. There are no relationship you need to have with any person or one person or multiple person that need to be greater than your relationship with Yahuwah. Y'all hear me?
Amen.
Because
amen.
Any other relationship that you have that's stronger is going to pull you away and make you transgress. I'm telling you, it's going to be a problem.
Amen.
Isn't that right? Just wondering the way don't you have your mother live down. I'm just asking. Wondering. People say that, and I know you love your mother. People might look and say, oh, that's crazy. That's your mother. That's when you go too far. I don't know how he said I came to put at variance. And it was conflict when she was there, wasn't it? If it wasn't, that meant you had to compromise. You had to go over to her. People don't realize that sometimes the things that hurt us and we feel like it hurts me, it's showing you when you comply with the word, it's going to be difficulties. There's no way for it not to be a problem. Because it don't, you know, they look at, dog, I can't do nothing. Everything I do wrong is simply because you don't know the word.
Mm.
And because you don't know the word and I've been apt and I'm able, capable of understanding, knowing the word, I'm able to identify every time you're doing something, say, you can't do that. If you would, don't do that. Because you don't realize without the mind and information of the word, they don't know. To them, it's just like, I can't do nothing right. That's a true statement. And you can't unless you have a teacher and a guide.
Right.
That's how you know what not to do. Right. That's why it's such a conflict and a problem. When you don't know, ain't no problem. What's wrong with people spending the night at your house they ain't mad? What's wrong with a woman landing here hanging up her pants and staying in your house? All you looking at, you helping somebody out versus, I can't help strengthen your hand and do wrong. Huh? What's wrong with a prayer that come on your house, they have something and people drinking? The Bible didn't say you can't drink. The Bible said don't get drunk. But you can't be that stupid. Y'all hear me? There's a lot of things if you sit around and do it. Like he said, there's a way that seems right unto a man, but the end thereof be the ways of death. Y'all hear me? That's why we start learning. We had to be so wise and had to be kind of so open to watch things and see the things and spot them right off when you see them. You don't. You want to get yourself caught up with a compromised situation. I say, because these people come, they crafty. They'll come at you, you'll think people innocent. Everybody come at you ain't innocent. It's just like the serpent. The book told you he was more sopped out than any other creature. Just sitting around, have a little conversation. Up here, the book told when sinners enticed thee,
sin thou not.
Then he said, thou will surely die. You telling me. Let me so if you miss one savage, what did you call it? You'll go to hell. You ain't gonna be saved no more. No, it ain't. I'm just asking, because I know the God I serve, he's merciful. I know mine merciful. I know he kind. You know what I'm saying? Your soul, if you miss one, you'll go to hell. Now you got to try to show them. that your God the same God they got. You wind up trying to prove yourself to these people. Prove nothing, he said. I'm going to prove to you by I'm going to stand on the wall.
Right.
In the fourth chapter of the book of Matthew, Yahoo, when Satan came to tempt Yahushua, he never consented to him one time. I mean, if you be who you say you are, I mean, calling, you know, you so saved, you should be able to come. Really, okay, well, won't you do this since you got, won't you come and try to save the rest of us? Take smooth like that. I mean, you since you got it right, Sister Mike, mm-hmm. won't you come and help us? We don't y'all yep. want to be saved too? Won't you come on to the party and help us get saved?
Yep.
See, they'll come to the right people and come to you persuasive with enough of that stuff. Before you know it, we got you right where we want you. Got you thinking you come to save us. No good done well, we ain't trying to be saved. We're going to pull you out and show you, you don't even believe what you've been talking yourself. Show you a hypocrite to what you believe. See, people have a whole nother agenda when they plan with you trying to get you to come to them. These people see, listen, these people already see how to trap you up. You got to be smart enough not to give in to him. Every time he came, he told me, get behind me. Made that man vanity from me. I ain't got time to keep fooling with this stuff. I done told you one time. Why don't you command them stone to be bread? You supposed to be so-called saved. You supposed to be in the truth. So they start challenging them if you're the truth, and then you got to prove to them you're in the truth by doing what? By showing them. Now you don't say him, you show you're not in the truth, because you don't say him, you start obeying them. You don't make these people a God. A God dictate, a God regulate, a God rule, a God command. Ain't got no business listening to what you're saying. You hear me? These folks will trap you up now. Yep. All right, let's see. What you got, son?
Colossians
3 and 1. Listen.
If ye then be risen with the Mashiach.
Listen what he told you to do.
Seek those things which are above.
Where who?
The Mashiach sitteth on the right hand of Elohim.
Set your what?
Affection.
On things where?
Above.
And not?
On things on the arits.
Tell them what happened, son.
For ye are dead.
And your who?
Life.
Is hid with who?
The Mashiach in Elohim.
What he told them to do?
When the Mashiach, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with him in glory.
So you should pay attention to that. When the Mashiach shall appear, then shall you appear with him in glory. On the third day, you know what the son did? It wound up appearing, showing itself, and it wound up demonstrating. And then it came on the third day, it showed you the moon and the stars. You ain't got them until the third day. So that when he shall appear, the book said we shall be like him. Huh? On the third day when you got the moon and when you got the stars. Huh? They came along emulating something. So this ain't something new. Another reason why you need to pay attention to this. What he tried to tell you if you be dead. How you ought to seek those things, which way it was again? Above, the reason you need to pay attention to that when he called Abraham. You know what he told him? Look at the star. That's what make you a descendant. Do you know what Abraham was looking for? He was looking for something in the Shamayims. He was looking for his descendant to be in the Shamayim. Why you think he told him to look at the stars? This is how I'm gonna make your descendant. So Abraham would have constantly in his walk, he'd have constantly been having a mind to do what? Redemption drawing now. Because this is something I'm holding to. This is what my descendant's going to be. Now, if you be dead, if you be risen with him, you're supposed to seek those things which are above. So he'd have been looking for the Shamayim and looking at the Shamayim. You know, they miss stuff like this. Y'all don't understand that, but you got to do something. This is what he told you.
Mortify, therefore, your members which are upon the already.
Which means you need to kill out some of these relationships. These relationships, I got one going now, causing relationships. Because you hadn't mortified. You ain't been looking at the things in the Shamayim. You've been looking at things in your panties. Yeah. You've been looking at things in your drawers. Bro, you've probably been looking at those things which are above, where the Mashiach sat on the right hand of the Father. You've probably been setting your affection now.
Yeah.
Your affection is your loving feeling. Your loving feeling ain't got no been in your drawers. That's why Abraham stayed consistent. Listen.
Fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, evil concupiscence and covetousness, which is idolatry.
For which?
Things sake.
The wrath
of Elohim.
Comes upon?
The children of disobedience.
That's what's going to get you. Why you think he wouldn't go back? Why you think he wouldn't let his son go back? He looked at what was going to happen. The wrath of Elohim going to come on the children of disobedience. Don't make no sense for me to go back. Don't make no sense to send my children back. Now, since we learned this about Abraham, there are some things we want to look now and we want to consider. Pick me up, son, in the second chapter of the book of Yochanan. What is the money? Thank you. Come on.
Beginning at verse 1.
2 and 1 be fine. Listen.
And the third day, there was a marriage in Cana of Galilee.
Y'all hear what happened? The third day, there was a marriage in Galilee. Third day. Listen.
And the mother of Yahushua was there.
What happened, son?
And both Yahushua was called.
And who else?
And his disciples.
Listen.
To the marriage.
Come on, son.
And when they wanted wine, the mother of Yahushua saith unto them, unto him, they have no wine. Yahushua saith unto her, woman, what have I to do with thee?
Yes.
Mine hour is not yet come.
Tell him what happened, son.
His mother saith unto the servants.
She said who?
Unto the servants.
What did she say?
Whatsoever he saith unto you.
What happened, son?
Do it.
Why would she do that? Why would she do that? Why would she do that? This is something y'all need to pay attention to. Back them up again, son. Let them listen to this. 2 and 3. What verse that was? 2 and 3 you just read?
That was 5.
2 and 3. Let me hear 2 and 3. Listen.
And when they wanted wine.
And when they wanted what?
Wine.
When they wanted what?
Wine.
What did they do, Brandon?
The mother of Yahushua saith unto him, they have no wine.
They have no what?
They have no wine.
What happened, son?
Yahushua saith unto her, woman, what have I to do with thee?
Yeah.
Mine hour is not yet come.
Talk to me, son.
His mother saith unto the servants, whatsoever he saith unto you, do it.
Probably just a chance she just made that statement. Probably just a chance. Bereshit chapter 41. Bereshit chapter 41. Let me hear verse 50. Bereshit chapter 41, verse 50. Listen.
And unto Joseph were born 2 sons before the years of famine came,
mm-hmm.
which Asenath, the daughter of Potipporah, priest of On, bare unto him.
Mm-hmm.
And Joseph called the name of the firstborn Manasseh, for Elohim said, he hath made me forget all my toil and all my father's house.
Listen.
And the name of the second called he Ephraim, for Elohim hath caused me to be fruitful on the land of my affliction.
Listen.
And the 7 years of plenteousness that was in the land of Mizraim were ended, and the 7 years of dearth began to come.
Listen.
According as Yosef had said.
What happened, son?
And the dearth was in all land.
The who?
The dearth.
Yeah. The scarcity of shortage was in all the land. What happened, son?
But in all the land of Mizraim, there was bread.
Listen.
And when all the land of Mizraim was famished, the people called to Pharaoh
the
for bread.
The people did what?
The people called to Pharaoh for bread.
They called to who?
Pharaoh.
For what?
Bread.
Who did they call for?
Pharaoh.
For what?
Bread.
What happened?
And Pharaoh said unto all the Egyptians.
What did he tell all the, what did he tell all the Mizraim?
Go unto Yahusuf.
Go to who?
Yahusuf.
For what?
What he said to you, do.
If you would, please look at your concordance, your side, and see if it references you over. See if I use columns. That's what he do. They don't pay attention to it. When it was a dirt, they ain't had nothing. They went, they had nothing. They went to Pharaoh to ask Pharaoh. So Pharaoh told him, go to him. Whatsoever he say do, do it. When they wanted wine, who you think they went to? They went to his mother. Huh? They went to his mother. You know why? Because your law told you to honor your mother and your father. You'd have told obey them in Yahuwah. This, that, not your law. Y'all don't know what y'all doing. I told them they don't know the man, didn't they? You just don't know him. Come on back to the second chapter and see what he did. Listen.
And there were set there 6 water pots of stone.
What happened?
After the manner of the purifying of the Yahudim.
Talk to me, son.
Containing 2 or 3 firkins apiece.
Uh-huh.
Yahushua saith unto them, fill the water pots with water.
Yeah.
And they filled him up to the brim.
Yeah.
And he saith unto them, draw out now and bear unto the governor of the feast.
Yes.
And they bear it. And the ruler of the feast had tasted the water that was made wine.
Yes.
And knew not whence it was.
Hold on for a minute. His mother just told him about making wine. They wanted some wine. He just told her, what I got to do with you? my hour is not yet come. So he still made the wine? Because that's your law. That's your law. These people don't know what they're doing. I try to tell them they don't know what they're doing. Why you think he told Abraham to go to their father's house? What's going to go back? What's going to happen you come back to the house, I tell you to get in and sit down? You got to obey. Huh? That's bad. I show how that worked. Because Abraham's daddy was dead, so he was safe to go back. 1 Timothy 5 and 1. Let's show how that worked. First Timothy 5 and 1. Listen.
Rebuke not an elder.
But do what?
Entreat him as a father.
And what else you want me to do?
And the younger men as brethren.
And what else?
The elder women as mothers.
So what you going to get back there, your aunt there, your mama there? Some of us, we grew up in the country. You got older relative, that cousin, you call them uncle and aunt because they older.
Yeah.
You can't rub them and treat them like no cousin. You got to treat them just like you do an aunt or uncle. You got to treat an uncle just like you treat your mother and father, don't you? Why you think he told him to get out of his, from his kindreds and from his father? He covered himself. Because he ain't say, I can't go back to my aunt in them house. See, these folks don't know what they're doing. I try to tell them, they don't know him. What you going to do then when you don't know him? They sit right out there thinking something. The man cover himself every time. Because I can't get you where you're going to sell and you're going to infraction the law. You're supposed to honor your mother and father. Honor your mother and father. But you're supposed to obey the ones that's in him. So you got mother and father. You can get that honor to him, but you ain't got to obey him. Now you got a situation where his mother and father in him, so you got to obey him. So she just came and told you they want some wine. Hey, what I got to do with you? My hour ain't yet come. Put that law. Fill them pots up. They don't know what they're doing. They admit, they think it's all about drinking, Darren. I try to tell them the whole time they come in my clear plan. Then what I do? My ministers already know they don't do. How long it took me to show y'all this? 2 minutes I put together for them. Sitting right there. We weren't even talking, didn't it? I shoot some stuff across on y'all so fast, y'all had no idea. Do this. Y'all have no idea. I can do a short work real quick. I just take y'all a long way and make sure you catch it. It don't take that long. Y'all play a lot, though. I try to tell you all the time, you don't know the man. You think you know him. You really don't know him. See, he covered himself. You got to honor your mother and father. You got to obey your mother and father that's in him. Let's show how he work on you. 19th chapter of the book of Ukanon. 19:25. That time I show y'all another twist on that too. Y'all have no idea how he covered himself. This man covered himself so many times. That's the only reason I work for him. You ain't gonna find no flaws. You ain't gonna find no defects in none of his teaching. He covered himself every time. Listen to the book.
Now there stood by the cross of Yahusha, his mother.
Who stood at the cross? His who?
His mother.
And who else?
And his mother's sister.
What happened, son?
Mareem, the wife of Cleophas.
Yes.
Mareem Magdalene.
Mm-hmm.
When Yahusha therefore saw his mother.
When he therefore did what?
Saw his mother.
What did he tell her?
And the disciple standing by.
Yes.
Whom he loved.
What happened, son?
He said unto his mother.
What did he tell his mother?
Woman, behold thy son.
What else he told him?
Then said he to the disciple.
Son, do what?
Behold thy mother.
What happened at that point?
And from that hour.
And from the next day?
From that hour.
From late on the night?
That hour.
What'd she do?
That disciple took her unto his own home.
What you think of him, your mama said that she tell you to come down? Huh? What you gonna do? You gonna transgress the law?
Can't do it. Can't do that.
Because I gotta honor my mother and father. But I gotta obey the ones in it.
Mm-hmm.
My mother in him. They don't know what they're doing. How many times I try to tell them? Go tell your father, probably ask him what happened, why he gave away his mother. I tried to tell them, they don't know him, they didn't. Can he cover himself? They don't know nothing about that man, do they? How many times I told him he was up on there on the two, he was doing more than one thing. You looking for one thing that man done, he does too much. Y'all still don't know everything he done on the two. I show you other twists to him. Y'all just don't know him. You can't hear without a preacher. And the preacher can't preach except he be sent. That's why I work for the man. Huh? He knew exactly what he had to do. Let me show you what he tried to tell the ninth chapter of the book of Oriah. Oriah chapter 19, chapter 9, verse 56. Other brother, we'll finish up at Matthew Yahoo chapter 13. Oriah chapter 9, make about verse 56. Listen to the book.
For the Son of Man is not come to destroy men's lives,
but
to save them.
Listen.
And they went to another village.
Yeah.
And it came to pass that as they went in the way, a certain man said unto him, Elohim, I will follow thee whithersoever thou goest.
What he say?
Elohim, I will follow thee whithersoever thou goest.
Talk to me, son.
And Yahusha said unto him.
What could he told him?
Foxes have holes.
And what has happened, son?
And birds of the air have nests.
Tell them about you, son.
But the Son of Man hath not where to lay his head.
He letting you know I don't live with my mom and dad. I had to get out. He had to get out.
Amen.
Same thing y'all didn't pick up, y'all didn't know about Yahusha. That's why he had to be cast out. He had to get out of his father's house. Huh? His father had rule over him. He never got a position, he'd have stayed in his father's house. His father loved him. His father ready to die when he heard what happened to him. You think his father allowed him to go through all that stuff and he'd have been there? He'd have been in his house? So he suffered him to be put out of his house. Huh? He suffered him to go in the land of Mizraim. A lot of times y'all wonder about these situations, why you had to break ranks and why you had to do what you do. Because it holds you back from being saved. I know a lot of them that get hit up. Princess, you one on the list too. Top of the list. First thing, I'm running mama. Call mama. Just lying, stand on your own. Y'all, that junk get on my nerve and I watch all that mama junk going back. Y'all got to get grown at some point. Stop counting on other folk to do stuff for you. Break ranks. Break ranks, learn to get independent for yourself. Abraham wound up being a stab, becoming a great man. His riches, everything was known. That man was one of the richest men in the land who left with nothing. Y'all don't put y'all mind to truly trust the man. Y'all keep them connected. You can always go back. You can always borrow. You can always get bailed out. And the whole time you keep that latch around your neck, you never break free. That's why you can't fully serve him. You look to fall, so you got a reason to call. You look to trip, so you got a reason to depend on him. I got others in here, too. They ain't the only one. I don't look to my mama, but none of it. I look to help my mama put something in her hand. The book told y'all you're supposed to be requiting your parents. Yeah. Oh, sorry, nigga, study be taking everything. The book told you to requite your parents. Yeah. Keep taking nothing from them. Folk done scuffed and raised and got you old and wiped your stinking behind. You still sitting sucking them dry. Mm. Disgrace and a done shame. Y'all don't grow up anywhere. Somebody break ranks and get on your feet. Yeah, beautiful way.
Amen.
Y'all hear me?
Amen.
Shoot, man, I remember when Henry Gray died. I look at Henry Gray, I said, man, I can fight the whole world. When he left here, I remember just before he died, I looked out the window. I got ready to cry. So I'm going to lose my daddy. I looked back around, I considered who I had, and looked at, I told him, he could take it rest. I was a man. Huh? A lot of folks be crying, worried about it, because they know you keep looking for somebody to carry you. Isn't that right, man? I lived that time. Man, I ran his course. He had no little kid to look after. I looked at and told my daddy he could take his rest. Huh? Let him know he could take his rest. I'm a man. Preached at funeral dinner. Y'all saw why I was staggering, I was hesitating, I was falling down and crying. My kid, y'all remember me breaking down crying? At home, instead of do my job. Had I raised a man. Can't be that for me all my life. Same thing with y'all grown, y'all suck y'all parents dry. Folk can't retire and live there and worry about y'all sorry behind these dumb decisions. Y'all step and get grown. So, but nigga, why I'm taking care of somebody grown working? How about him ain't sitting back, go ahead, my dad got a bar or something. You hit baby girl, you go back and ask him. How can y'all quit being sorry? Dang, y'all about to be going back requiting them, giving, putting something back in their hands, send something back to help them out. Mm-hmm. Sucking them doing dry for everything they got. Then try to run in here and play save. Go contrary to what y'all being taught. Isn't that right? One thing gives somebody a boost, another thing to give you my doing better out my car. Can I hold, listen, what is it? An engine, some tires, some doors, a roof? Nigga, that's a car. Yeah. I raise y'all up, man. Y'all gotta learn how to stand. Yeah. That's a pressing way for us. I want everybody to see you have no handout. See you something coming giving. Couldn't anybody that junk get on my nerve? Just look bad on us. Why y'all can't serve a tithe? It don't mean you hate him. It's just at some point you got to realize he called me out from with you. It was a situation now. You crippled me. You hindered me being there. It ain't always because of them. It's because of you. You always had them as a dependency. And now you always could lean to them. You always knew they'll clean up your mess. He realized if you're going to be saved, you got to break that. You got to trust me all the way. You don't trust me or you rot in hell. You can't serve him told. You can't have two masters. Master tell you, what you gonna do? Your mama tell you what to do. But I don't want to care about no church. What no? I'm your pastor. Get your behind in him. Now you ain't no band. Now you're in a conflict. Like Shaul, now you're in a straight between two. Bad thing you do, you got from their rule, got money in their house, and you got to give them back their money. Give them back, I don't want that control. Right. I don't want to get nobody that control no more. He got to have control. Y'all hear me? I got to break ranks on that. I got to have it where he got all control. I can't do that when I'm talking about something. Listen, you can't tell me what to do. Can I borrow $500? Listen, I go where I want to go. Can we get $1,000? Shut your mouth. Shut your mouth. I got to break ranks on that jump. Start standing. Come back, tell you sometimes it's better just do without. They respect you better. My in-law got to respect me. I don't go ask him for a dime. I ain't send my wife back for nothing from him. Amen. Want nothing from him. Ain't that right? Just keep it. Right. Anything, I'll send something back over there. Y'all hear me? Then my wife, parents, she tell my mom, dad, I can help. I'm going to do my part. What they need. I know that's how mama said. I ain't studying them. They ain't what they need. Try to help them out. I know that's how much you love her parents. I ain't trying to take nothing from them. Cause I want them to come and say, look here, boy, I'll help you in it. Because at that point, we finna have a duel. I'm saying, turn, we're going to take three steps. One, three. Bust that joker. That old joker might get a lucky shot off. Ain't that right? One step, then three, and shoot me in the back. Isn't that right? It's at best you keep things where they respect you better. He don't like what I got. They got respect, but they know they see me coming. They ain't got to duck high because here I come from another old lying story. Ain't that right? Make where they got respect you when they see you. And I expect what I got. I don't have no junk going on. That's how you got to be. Y'all hear me? I'm trying to help a whole lot of y'all out with some of this stuff. Y'all done. You got to learn to cut ties on that stuff. They ain't going to respect you like that. You get a failure, you got to learn at some point, I got to break them ties of coming to you for stuff. It was good when it left, but I got a wife and I got a family. I got to move. Same thing to wife. Learn to do without. Some of y'all, them light cut off a little bit, you'll see better. You'll see where your error's at. So when they said cut off notice in 95 days, they mean 95 days. So that guy outside who I cussed out and called him a mother, he really can take that meat off the side of the house. See, you start learning better. When you get real cold at night on a cloudy day, you'll see. You start learning. You need to, so you don't take them bills and lay them down. They don't open themselves and send money in a stamp envelope back by themselves. You need to open them and pay them and get them out at a proper time so your stuff don't get cut off. You start learning then. So that guy out there who I cussed out and had my car jacked up, I thought it was changed out, he really can take my car back. Yes, he can when you're old. So you start getting responsible. You start learning, I got to take care of what I got. I got to be more prompt about it. I got to start being responsible. I got to look at what I get myself into because I don't want to get myself in a situation where I could going back to them for money, then they wind up making me look like a child or treat me like a child. Because it's going to be hard to go back and tell them, you don't treat me like a man. Now let me borrow $500. It's going to be hard to treat you like a man or a woman. I'm going to treat you just like you. You still my little child. Because my little child always come in and need money, so you will always be my little child. Now you're feeling, I don't like when they say that. Thank you, Mom. Be adult then.
Yeah.
Get responsible. Look at what you got. Take care of your business.
Yeah.
Goodness, boy, I had to teach y'all everything. But that's why I'm here. Yeah. All right, finish that 13th chapter. Matthew Yahoo 13, 48. I'm going to let y'all go. Y'all all right?
Yes,
did y'all learn something today?
Yes,
good, good. Good, good. Listen to the book.
Again, the kingdom of Shamayim is likened to a net that was cast into the sea and gathered of every kind.
And?
Which, when it was full, they drew to shore and sat down and gathered the good into vessels, but cast the bad away.
What happened, son?
So shall it be at the end of the world.
Mm-hmm.
The Malachi shall come forth and sever the wicked from among the just. And shall cast them into the furnace of fire. There shall be wailing and gnashing of teeth. Yahusha saith unto them, have ye understood all these things? They say unto him, yea, Yahusha. Then said he unto them, therefore every scribe which is instructed unto the kingdom of Shamayim is like unto a man that is an householder, which bringeth forth out of his treasure things new and old.
Get the most high hand clap.
Amen.